There's no point in coming to the Minnesota Renaissance Fair without learning about the Renaissance period of Minnesota. So for the next 3 hours, we will be discussing... No? No? 5 minutes. For the next 5 minutes, we'll be discussing the Renaissance period in Minnesota, interviewing as many people as we can, and hopefully not making too big fools of ourselves.
This here is history in motion. The Minnesotan Renaissance was a difficult period for everyone. Yes, there was enlightenment and glory and a bunch of other things, but really it was a hard time, and it was a time of change. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times.
No, that's Dickens. That's Dickens.
It was the best of Dickens, it was the worst of Dickens.
Well, okay, hang on. We really don't want to go there.
It was a thing, and yet it was also another unrelated thing.
There you go.
Renaissance. So here we are with the lovely...
Red?
Little Red.
Little Red? Okay, very nice. So I'd like to ask you a couple questions about the Minnesotan Renaissance in particular. So this is traditional Minnesotan garb.
I'm a wench.
Okay, so how you doing?
Good, thank you. How are you?
No, I'm doing okay. So basically my viewers want to know more about the tradition behind the Renaissance Fair. And I'm seeing you here in traditional Minnesotan garb. So could you just explain some of that?
Actually, this is my first time ever here, and I figured might as well try to
find in. So you're not really familiar with the history of the Renaissance of Minnesota?
Not really.
Not really? Are you from Minnesota?
Yeah.
You're really? You gotta study up, dude. You gotta study up. Seriously. Okay. Are you a traditional Minnesotan wench?
Yeah, I'd say so.
You'd say so? Okay, so what are your wenching duties?
I work for Grandma.
You work for Grandma. Okay, hi Grandma.
Hello.
It's as big as my face. I'm gonna call it Junior. Sweet,
Cannibal.
Delicious Junior. Hi, hello everyone. So, I'm interviewing people about the Renaissance Fair here, and I would like to comment and ask people about your traditional Minnesotan garb that you're wearing right now. Can you tell me a little bit about the Minnesotan history? Because this is the Minnesotan Renaissance Fair, after all. So I'd like to know, is this traditional Minnesotan garb, or?
Yes, as you know, peacocks are native to Minnesota.
Right.
So this garb is made of peacock feathers. Minnetonka,
okay.
Minnetonka peacocks, that's why okay. They're so bright.
Right, okay, that makes sense.
yep, and mine is crushed metal from Lake Superior.
Lake Superior, which is superior to the other lakes, of course.
Oh, definitely.
Of course, definitely.
I don't know about the Minnetonka peacocks, but I got the Minnetonka moccasins.
Oh, very nice.
That is true.
So that actually is historic.
Yeah, that is
actually, that actually is historic. Okay, so I'm trying to, you know, be an ass and make a joke, and you actually give me something legitimate. Yeah, you ruined everything. You ruined everything. But, you know, that's okay.
No, you've gone too far!
Yeah, I did good.
Today, we leave you with a special, special moment. Crazy drunk guys making fun of people on a bridge. They were making fun of people before.
Oh well.
Where's your hook shot?
Still looking for it. Haven't been to the water temple yet.
The water temple is such a pain. How do you make it through that? Seriously. Like, every time I go there, it's just like, water goes up, water goes down, water goes up, water goes up, push the block. Like,
and they gotta put the boots on, they gotta take the boots off, and then it's a nightmare.
Okay, well, you know, keep saving the princess for us, man. Okay. I mean, no matter how many times you get stuck, keep doing it. For us. All right, thank you very much.
Hey, no problem.
Ren Faire. Awesome.
I give up.
I'm done. Can't do it.
He tried. He did his damnedest. He did a good job.
Try again next year.